Well, it has grown phenomenally over the last 27 years, and we originally started off as a part of United Cerebral Palsy of Lehigh Valley, and Monroe and Pike were kind of the northern extension of that organization, and they felt it was a little far afield for them, and they were going to close our programs down up here. But with some very civic-minded people, we got together in 1982, I believe it was, and formed our own board and wrote our own bylaws and et cetera. And we became Developmental Education Services of Monroe County. And at that time, we hired Sue Folk as our executive director. Hopefully, we can continue to provide all the services necessary for Monroe County.
Can you give a smile? That's good.
I believe she was 3 months. She was 3 months.
Really?
3 or 4 months. We brought her in for an evaluation and got, actually the news we didn't want to hear was that she was actually eligible for services. I was in denial at the time, as most parents are, but I was trying really hard to deny that there was anything wrong with her. If she continued to receive some services even then, she received, I believe, home-based occupational therapy. Services. So she was a DES family person for at least 4 years. Mm-hmm. At least 4 years. And
over the years, in what way has DES helped her cope with whatever disability she had?
Well, if it wasn't for all the therapies and the intense therapies that they gave her when she was an infant toddler, I don't think she would be doing anything that she's doing now. Jillian has a genesis of the corpus callosum and microcephaly, and with that, the two halves of her brain aren't connected. And we were giving a very bleak diagnosis of that she was blind, deaf, mentally retarded, and cerebral palsy through the services at DES. Working with her, first of all, they helped us to accept her diagnosis, and then also to see that it wasn't as bleak a diagnosis as we thought it was. They gave us hope and they gave us promise and support.
You've had a lot of challenges over the years. Mm-hmm. How has DES helped you?
DES was there for me. And my family, not only myself and my ex-husband, but my children, grandparents, we were all welcome here. We were all trained. We were all given the support that we needed. I'm getting choked up as I talk about it. There was many a times that I came in to DES when she was a baby, really discouraged and really depressed. And the support that they gave me, along with other family members, but me in particular, who was having a really tough time accepting how severely involved my child was. They helped me get through the really difficult years, and to find out that, or to come to the point that it was okay to have a child who was different, that she was going to enrich my life and give me happiness and joy, no matter what her abilities or disabilities were. Very, very supportive, I can't say that enough. They were always there to listen, to talk. They always had resource materials for me to take home to read. They had family days, family events, so that my boys, who were young at the time, were able to be pulled into the therapies and the support. They never had a closed door policy. We were always welcome. And no matter what her therapies were scheduled for, if I needed more time, there was always somebody there who would take the time to listen to me and to give me the encouragement that we needed. They also were wonderful with the amount of services that they gave Jillian. She had intense needs, especially in the physical areas, and the quality and the quantity of the therapies that she received were very beneficial in helping her to develop. DES is a family. DES is a family of support, a family of friends, a family of professionals who can provide the therapies and meet your child's needs.
That's good.
That was good. I didn't freeze up either.
And now DES is getting ready for one of their biggest challenges of the 27 years. We are trying to get funds to renovate a permanent home for our services. We have leased properties and, you know, you're kind of at the whim of the landlord whether the building needs to be sold or this or that. And we found a property, we purchased it. It's the former Sebring's Powerhouse. And now we are doing a capital campaign to raise funds for the renovations. And it's an important step in the growth of this agency. To have a permanent home here in Monroe County after serving for 27 years. We welcome all inquiries here at Developmental Education Services, 796 Lindbergh Street in Stroudsburg. Phone calls, 570-424-5410, or you can check us out on our website, www.devedmc.org. That's DEVEDMC.org. Thank you very much for your interest, and we welcome you.